This week on Maker Update, a shopping cart with a mind of its own, sequencers with Furby ears, a disco coaster, and an extractor for heat set inserts. Hello and welcome to 2025, and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where you go to get updated on all the cool things that makers are making. I'm Tyler Weingartner, and I hope you're all doing great. We've got a wonderful show for you, so why don't we get started with the project of the week. Have you ever wanted to drive around your shop? Well, whether you have or haven't, that's what Austin Blake is doing with his autonomous go-kart. You see, this is actually his second autonomous kart project. The first one he would test at a local park with a series of sidewalks that resembled a racetrack. But that was a pain to get everything out there anytime he wanted to improve the model, and the local wildlife kept going through his stuff. Which is why he arrived at this version 2, the autonomous crazy kart. This kart is powered by a single wheel towards the front of the kart, which also handles the steering. The rest of the kart is stabilized by these caster wheels. What this means is that the kart can make some really tight turns, perfect for the next step, establishing a race course in his shop where he can test anytime he likes. The machine learning technique he's using to train the model is called behavioral cloning. Basically, he drives the kart around the track several times so the model can learn what it's supposed to be doing, and then it tries to replicate the behavior as best as it can. There's a potentiometer attached to the wheelchair motor that he's using for steering, so he can get feedback on the current steering position. But the only way for the car to tell where it's going is through a trio of webcams. After adding some detail to the track edge, he's beginning to get some promising results. Initially, he was helping the model along by just letting it worry about the steering while he managed the throttle. But eventually, he took the training wheels off and let it run on its own. It's a cool project, and in both of his videos, he goes into a ton of depth about how this driving model works. Check it out if you want to dive into this kind of project. More projects. The 2024 Maker a Secret Santa happened over the past few weeks. And one of our favorites is this sequencer Becky Stern made out of a PlayStation 4 controller for Sam from Look Mom No Computer. This project began around 2 years ago, around the time that she developed her PlayStation 4 breakout board. This allows her easy access to all the button inputs from the controller. Perfect for this project. But she hit a few frustrating snags along the way, forcing this project onto the shelf for a while. But getting Sam as her Secret Santa recipient was just the right motivation she needed to get this project back on track. She utilized a technique called rubber duck debugging, which is where you explain your whole project in detail to a rubber duck or other inanimate object. It sounds strange, but it's a useful technique for talking yourself through any potential problem it might have and where the solutions lay. The sequencer plays sounds collected from Sam's museum, and there's even a light-up Furby ear for that personal touch. Sometimes folks take a project and supersize it, and sometimes they go the opposite direction. Bitluni has made this desktop version of his LED walls, and it looks fantastic. He's made two versions, a 6x6 grid and an 8x8 grid. This is his own custom board that uses these individual four-leg LEDs that function like a single addressable LED. But if you put them in a series, they work in a chain like you'd expect them to. But the real surprise are these pogo pins on every single side of the frame. The matrix and the pattern it displays can be extended by simply snapping on an additional tile. It's super cool, and you can get all the parts you need to build your own by following the links down in the description. Now for some tips and tools. It's easy to love heat set inserts. They're satisfying to install, add great function to your 3D printed parts, and they look good too. But what if you ever need to remove them? You stand a really good chance of damaging your print, and maybe even your tools. Stefan at CNC Kitchen has developed a remover for heatset inserts. It fits onto the end of your soldering iron, and then you slide it over the head of these special copper screws. Once the heat from the extractor transfers into the plastic, the insert is ready to extract. Clever stuff. When you're a generalist, you tend to acquire a lot of tools. And when you have a bunch of tools, they tend to be in the way when you're not using them. That's the problem that Wesley Treat is having, which is why he's making a few custom boxes for some of his lesser used tools. Not only does this give him an opportunity to build a sturdy storage case for his slip roller, but he's also able to make a few additions to the tool to make it easier for him to work with. This is the sort of project that can come from noodling around in your shop, but it really can make life easier for you. And finally, Barnso has a guide on how to make any cable retractable. This is a simple system of pulleys that takes up the slack when you don't need it, but easily feeds it out when you do. To give it some necessary slack for easy working, there's a cam mechanism to lock it in place when you have the cable at the length you want. It's simple, but really effective. What's more, this video makes for a really satisfying watch since he's using nothing but hand-powered tools to make this. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, Shawn, Hymel has a new teaching series on DigiKey, and this one is all about getting your head around FreeCAD. FreeCAD is, like the name suggests, a totally free and open source parametric CAD solution, and it just hit its 1.0 release a few months ago. The first two episodes are already available, and it's a 10-part series where he already has each episode planned out. He also pretty honestly compares it to other CAD packages, so you get an idea whether this time investment is right for you, even if there's no monetary investment. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. As always, you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe with the bell so you don't miss the next one. As always, huge thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.